amongst the huge range of word processing apps, Wisdom Writer is definitely one you want to check out for some of its unique features and its ease of use.
So when you first open Wisdom Writer, you actually get this document comes up, and it's a welcome document. It's read-only. But the first thing to note with Wisdom Writer is they basically want to make writing a new document as easy as possible. So the easiest way to start a new document is drag from the very left to the very right of the screen, and it opens up a new document for you. So I'm basically straight into writing mode. The first thing to note is you've got a hashtag in front of this, what I've written as my document title. You can actually set up different levels of headings and subheadings, and paragraph font. So on this H tab, you can see you can have 6 levels of headings, and then P is just when you want paragraph text. So you can either click and hold and then drag to a particular level heading. So I drag to level 4 for a heading. Or if you just wanted to write paragraph text and not have headings, just go down to the P. Also, if you click and hold and go back to the H settings, you can actually just tap to cycle through the 6 heading levels and the paragraph level. So let's go down to our next line, and it's gone straight to a paragraph level. So you've got your standard keyboard that you can use, and then there's a second level on the keyboard with some other options. So you've got indent and outdent options there. You've got undo and redo options. You've got insert lists. So I can actually click and hold on there, and I could insert a numbered list. And it just keeps going, inserting new numbers on your list. When you finish with the list, you can just enter past the line and it'll remove the list. There is a great option on the list. There's a checklist option. So you can put in some checklist items for you. And then you can actually use those as a checklist. So you can click once for a circle to say it's underway. Click again, it gives you a tick on your checklist. So that's a great option as well. You've got an insertion tab here, so you can insert, it starts off with web links, tables, an image from your camera's photo album. You can take a photo, or there are some other functions there for inserting various types of formatting or lines. So we'll insert a table. So within the table, you can either just click on different cells, or you can actually move around the table with these buttons. If you click in a cell and hold, you get a secondary menu, so insert, quote levels, select table, you can add rows and columns. So we could add another row before, there we go. And then you can just add in the various text that you want in the cells. So as you saw, there's the ability to add in images from your camera roll, once it has access. Drop a picture in. If you want to format the image a bit, remove the keyboard, click and hold on the image, and you get these orange tabs. Then you can click on size, and it gives you some size choices. So I could take it down to 10% of the size, or up to 50, etc. And you can do increments of plus minus 10 as well. Another great option for insertion is a link. So you can actually insert a URL. So you can put in the address and text to display, and you can give it a title. Click save, and it puts in a link. So when I click on that link in the active document, it'll head off to the URL. There are a couple of other link types. So in the user guide, you can actually see you can put in your standard web URLs, but if you wanted to link to an email address, you can format it like this: mail2:, and then the email address. You can also link from one document to another document. So if you put in the document name, whatever it is, .txt, it should link through to that document. And you can actually link to various sections within a document. So if you want to link to a particular heading, you put in the heading of the hashtag and then the heading name. So there's some great features for linking throughout the app. The other tab is worth looking at. This one is a delete in front or delete behind. So if I click this, it'll delete the A. If I click and hold and go to the other option, it'll start deleting backwards. So let's undo those last couple of deletions. Then this last set is navigation tabs. So I can move forward and back one letter at a time. If I click and hold, I can get some other options. I can move up and down one line at a time. You can do double jumps, so up and down two lines at a time. You've got move forward and backward by one word at a time. And then you can also go to home, so you can go to the start or the end of the document. And the last one, you can jump and select whole sections of the document. So there's some useful ways to move through the document. With the text, you can put in quote levels. So if this is a quote, I can put in a particular level of a quote. So as you tap increase or decrease, it puts the quote level up by one. You can go up to quite a few levels there, so I'm up to six, or you just decrease back to the desired quote level. You can also put in pre-formatted block text. If you select a certain section and then you click on this button, it puts it into pre-formatted block for the text that you've selected. Just like most standard word processing apps, if you click and hold, you get secondary menus. So let's bring up the keyboard, click on a word, I get an option here, I can select all. You can insert various things, links, tables, footnotes, etc., lines. So there's some good options. For example, if you insert a footnote, title for your footnote, inspirationally I'll call it footnote. This is at the bottom. And click save, and that will pop a footnote. So it's put a footnote within the word, and then when I actually print the document, it doesn't appear on this version, the typed version in the app, but when I print the document, my footnote will then read, this is at the bottom. So that's a useful setting. Also, you can change text colors. So if I select a word, I can then do bold, underline, copy. You can suggest links, you can format your text, so you can change size, color, etc. And you can look at a few other options, copy HTML, and there's some markdown language settings as well. When you're finished with the document and you want to go to just reading mode, tap to remove the keyboard, and now you're into reading mode. And when you go into that mode, you get a secondary menu that comes up. So the couple of buttons in the left, one takes you to a view of all your documents. So you can see that the Wisdom Writer has their own folder with a bunch of introductory documents. But I've got my draft folder, and initially all of the documents you make will go into the draft folder. There's also the possibility to link a Dropbox account, which is a must. And the good thing is, once you link a Dropbox folder, your draft folder, where all of your documents, your new documents, unless specified, they all go into your draft folder, this now sits in your Dropbox account. So your documents will always be backed up to the server. So in the Dropbox folder, I can now see there's a draft folder where the documents will go to. Now, something else on this menu, you can see down here you've got a little tab that says Files or Docs. So if I leave files highlighted, it shows me all the folders and all of the documents that sit outside folders. But if I just click on Docs, it'll just show me the documents within various folders. Okay, so that's a good way to sort through and see different levels of categorization, folders or just files. Also, you can search through your files and documents. So let's search for the word welcome, and you can see it's already bringing up just those two documents. With welcome in the title. So that's another good feature for looking through all of your documents. There's a few other tabs within here. So you've got a plus button, which allows you to add new documents from within this management section. So I could pick a particular folder in my Dropbox account, click on plus, and it will make me a new document within that folder. Okay, so I made that document, called it music, and it's within my music folder on my Dropbox account. So it's been added there, which is a good feature. You can make a new folder, so you can click on the folder with a little plus if you actually want to create new folders to get a bit more organization within your file storage. So if I go into my draft folder, I could make a new one, test files, and that'll give me a new folder. So I could then make documents or place documents within that. The other possibility is organization tab. So if I click on that, I get the possibility to organize it alphabetically, or reverse alphabetically, order of date, most recent or least recent. So just another way to organize things. The next option here, you've got an edit tab, so you can actually edit either folders or files. If I click on edit, it will allow me to delete whole folders, or I can actually enter in to a particular folder, and you can change the name of the folder and change its storage path. Or if we click on done, I could actually go in to a document there, click on edit, tap on that document, and it'll let me change some of the details of that document as well. I can move the file to a different storage location. So there's some good options there for editing your documents. Another way to view all of your documents is if you pinch on a file that you're working on, it takes you to this overview screen, and you can basically drag left or right and see all of the documents that you've been working on. If you drag all the way to the left, you get an option to create a new blank document. It also gives you this secondary menu down here, so you can choose to delete a document, which I will do for that one. You can duplicate a document, so this test document, I could make another copy. You can tap on the information tab, comes up with document name, which you can change from this screen. You can also look at the location of the file and move it, and then just see when it was last modified and the file size. There is a preview button, so you can get a document and you can hit this preview button. And now from the preview screen, you could then share the document from that screen once you've had a look and decided if you're happy with it. Click on the share tab. You get options to open in, print, send via email, copy, etc. So some good options there. Another interesting feature to notice is these little colored boxes. Instead of having file paths where it's backslash, backslash, it actually has boxes, color-coded boxes for the location for your file. So this test document is stored in the local folder in the draft folder. And you'll see the same if we go to overview of documents. You can see here, this shows you that all of these documents are actually stored in the same place. So these are all the Wisdom documents. They're in the local folder in the Wisdom Writer folder, whereas the couple I've made are in local and draft, and that one was in Dropbox and Music. So that's sort of a unique, interesting way, I think, and a good way of giving you an idea of Dropbox location. You can see it visually by color-coded boxes. Another good feature is with the ability to put in different heading levels. I've made a few different heading levels for this document, so I've got a couple there. I've got a few further on, so that's a level 5 heading and a level 2 heading. Just to illustrate a point, in the top right-hand corner, you can search through your document by the headings. So I can click on the headings that are test document, types, level 2, etc., and it'll jump me through to those places in my document. So that's quite a useful way to get through to navigate around your document as well. There's also an font button, so you can choose some preset styles. So normal, you can do Wisdom 1, Wisdom 2, and you can do a night setting. You also have the ability to change the font settings as well yourself a little bit, and the font size to some degree. So there's some reasonable options there. The last one is your settings tab. So you've got some extra tools. You can do find and replace. You can look at your metadata, view your document options. You can lock documents, etc. You can have pin protection on documents and a few other settings, auto correction, etc.
So there's plenty of apps we can compare Wisdom Writer to. I'd love to know what you think. Head across to the Facebook page, iPadagogy. Don't forget to follow the Twitter feed, @i_pedagogy, and remember to subscribe for more excellent videos.